We had a problem with our Torqeedo Cruise 4.0 motor. The controller for the motor wouldn't power up.
We bought two circuit boards, the only two that you can replace, but we're only going to replace one, which is the master controller circuit board.
We have to open up the motor in order to replace the circuit board.
So I have a 2mm Allen wrench here, and we're going to remove these screws here.
We start by removing these four screws, and you can see they have tiny little washers associated with them.
Okay, but now we're going to remove this and this.
Once we get the plate off, we find there are two more screws that need to be removed, and so we end up with four little screws and a plate. And there's one more plate to be removed from behind the power cable. And now we remove the top of the motor. There are some cables that are attached, so you have to be careful.
There's the GPS cable, the soft start circuit board cable. There's the cable to the motor and the cable to the throttle.
So we're going to remove this ribbon cable.
And we have one more cable connector to remove.
Now the question becomes, how is this board held on? And I think it's held on with double stick tape. Because if you look at this board, there's no mounting hardware here.
With the same wrench, we can unscrew two more screws and disengage the circuit board that we're trying to replace.
Okay, there's a nylon washer that goes underneath each one of these, and then there's a stainless washer too. So that's something to keep in mind.
So using a razor blade utility knife, we can separate the board from the backing plate. There are two pieces of double stick tape that mount the board to the plate. Next, we mount the new board to the plate so we don't forget how it was mounted. We start with brand new double stick tape.
So the board goes like this. So now we put it all back together.
So we're going to remount the screws with the silicone washers and the stainless steel washers back to the plate that held them. Getting the silicone washers on is a little tricky, but it's doable with pliers. Then we tighten up the bolts with the hex wrench again. Next, we reconnect all the connectors. Then, starting in reverse order, we reconnect every screw and plate that we had removed. Before we replace the top of the motor, we need to check the O-ring that seals the motor so that water doesn't get in.
Then we can replace the top of the motor and fasten everything back together with the screws that we removed at the beginning. We also replace the other set of screws with the plates around the pigtails and the cables.
Okay, that is done. Okay, I'm gonna plug this in. Okay, it's plugged in. So now, will it light up?
Woo! It lights up! So it was just that one circuit board.
Yeah.
And we changed it and it works. All right, we got power.
Thanks for watching this Torqeedo motor repair video. Please subscribe to CB99 videos and give us a super thanks if you can.